Baseball at its best. It's going to be the Cincinnati Reds as they play the St. Louis Cardinals at Busch Stadium. Live on 2K Sports.
Sunday afternoon. Great game ahead. 2K Sports with Steve Phillips and John Kruk. I'm Gary Thorne. Hi, everybody. Tremendous force at the plate. Maybe the game's best ball player right now, Albert Pujols. Also, the site of the 2009 All-Star Game, St. Louis and Busch Stadium. Let's take a look at who's going to be starting for the Cardinals. And, Steve, as he gets into the Cincinnati lineup, what are we expected to see?
A pretty good matchup for this right-hander on the mound right here. This is the lineup that he should be able to carve his way through. Not many threats in this lineup for him.
We've got a moment to check out that lineup for the Reds.
Now, some kind of offense right here. Star-studded lineup and really great length and depth with guys that really can put the ball in play.
Rose up at the plate. Cardinals taking a loss in their last outing. It makes it two in a row. They're looking to at least pick up one here against Cincinnati.
Well, and this team is starting to fade a little bit in the standings recently. Three wins in their last 10 ball games, so they're going to need to put together a more consistent effort and sustain it through the duration of this season.
There's a swing, line drive, center field. Well, that's a good start. First batter, first hit. Now we'll take a quick look at the Cardinals and how they're lined up on the field. John, thoughts on the fielders here?
Well, Albert Pujols has played multiple positions throughout his career, but really has entrenched himself at first base as one of the best in baseball.
On tap for the Cardinals. This game, the last against Cincinnati, they'll have tomorrow off. And they'll travel to deal with Carlos Lee. A travel schedule moves them on to Houston. That should be a great series. They really match up well. That'll be a three-game series. Then there's another stop on the road trip. The Braves at Turner Field. So they'll be on the road quite a bit over this next stretch. Runner on first base. Nobody out. Morgan hits the ground ball.
Well, it's not going to take a genius to figure out that the hot zone for most major league hitters is a fastball right down the middle of the plate. That's exactly what the pitcher threw him, and that's why he got hit hard.
And bench settles in. No one out yet. Runners at first and second. Here's the pitch. Ball. Off the plate, low, 1-0. At the belt, the 1-0. Slider waved at, missed, 1-1.
Well, you see that pitch coming in, and it starts at the center of the plate, and all of a sudden, as soon as you start your swing, that's when that slider starts breaking away, gets out of the strike zone away. He can't stop his swing and swings and misses.
Now the 1-1. Sharp bite to that slider, 1-2.
Gets the first out of the inning right there. Now let's see if he can continue to bear down, work his way out of this jam, and keep the score tied.
And Foster's in the box.
It's been a long time for the Cincinnati Reds to make to the playoffs. Not only did they finish over 500, which was a surprise, they actually won the division, one of the more shocking things from 2010.
Runners on first and second with one out. Shot back to first, into the corner, likely extra bases, and they can't cut it off. It'll roll to the wall. And he will score from second base. And Morgan follows him home. And he'll stop at second base. That'll be a two-run double. Those two RBIs, boy, that makes a difference. We can see just how much on this WPA chart.
Well, this is a great job right here. He did what was necessary. Look, he would have loved to have been able to drive in one, but the fact that he got the bonus plant with that big hit to drive in two to put his team up 2-0, that's huge.
One out with a runner at second. Cut on and missed, and it's 0-1. And to make it even more shocking, it wasn't necessarily about pitching, which we talk about all the time. Yeah, they had that, but it really was the offense that drove them to the top.
Most runs scored in the National League, most home runs in the National League. They were the cream of the crop in run production in 10.
Here's the pitch. Swing liner back up the middle. Makes its way through for a single.
I tried to go down with that 0-1 pitch, but it gets blasted right back for the base hit.
But the way he went after that in the box, Steven, looked like he might have been guessing down there.
Well, I'll tell you what, you have to make contact behind in the count. He got a pitch over the heart of the plate and took advantage of it.
We hope you can't get enough baseball. There'll be more this Saturday. It's going to be Sean Figgins. Cardinals, their losing streak could move on. They lost yesterday. It makes it two in a row. They're looking to at least pick up one here against Cincinnati. Here's the delivery.
Ball.
Slider just misses, 1-0. That last one, the offense really not getting it done.
Nah, just one run scored, and that's not going to get it done. These bats have to come alive in this game.
Pauses, and now the 1-0. Strike. Swings and misses at the fastball. That'll even the count at 1.
It's been a long time for the Cincinnati Reds to make to the playoffs. Not only did they finish over 500, which was a surprise, they actually won the division, one of the more shocking things from 2010.
Strike. And here's a called strike at the letters, and it's 1-2. And to make it even more shocking, it wasn't necessarily about pitching, which we talk about all the time. Yeah, they had that, but it really was the offense that drove them to the top.
Most runs scored in the National League, most home runs in the National League. They were the cream of the crop in run production in 10.
And he pops it up. Foul territory behind third. Good effort there, but he couldn't get into position to make that play. The 1-2 pitch. A swing and a foul off to the right side.
Well, you know the pitcher wants to get this strikeout right here, but the last thing he wants to do when he's ahead in the count is make a mistake. And the more balls he keeps fouling off in tough situations, the more chance of a mistake coming. Pitcher has to keep his focus right here.
Here it comes. Fastball got him, two down.
Well, this is just giving away an at-bat right here. With two strikes on you, you've got to make him bring it in the zone or at least foul off the pitch. Now he's walking back to the dugout.
Now we'll take a quick look at the Cardinals and where they'll be fielding. Any picks, John?
Well, Albert Pujols has played multiple positions throughout his career, but really has entrenched himself at first base as one of the best in baseball.
Two men on, two men out.
Ball.
First pitch, a slider outside, 1-0.
When you throw a breaking ball like this, you want to start it on the corner and break it off the zone, trying to get the hitter to chase. The hitter didn't take the bait here.
Let's the 1-0 pitch go by, 1-1.
Well, it's a quality fastball right there, just pounding the strike zone down and away. He had no chance to put that one in play.
Good looking fastball. Called the ball, though, 2-1. Now the 2-1. There's a swing and a liner. And there's the third out. And it didn't take long. Our first two runs, first inning, trouble coming. Cincinnati's out in front, 2-0. And we'll take a look at Cincinnati's starter. And as he gets going against these St. Louis hitters, what do you think's in store?
Now this right-hander has quality stuff, and it doesn't really matter oftentimes who he's facing. If he executes his pitches and pitches his game, he's got a chance to come out on top.
Here's the pitch. He's at 0-2. He watched that fastball that was in there.
Well, the hitter's dug himself a pretty deep hole right here. Let's see if he can battle himself out of it.
Swung on, line to right center field. And the leadoff man's on board. You love the offense when it gets going that way. Pulls into second with that double, so he's in scoring position now with nobody out.
You see it coming up in the zone over the heart of the plate. Good piece of hitting, drives that ball.
Boy, if there's a pitcher wants back. There's one right there.
That's good pitch recognition, good two-strike approach.
And Ozzie Smith in. He's the team's most walked batter. Base runner at second with nobody out. Spins, checks him at second. Here's the pitch. Fastball misses away. 1-0. The 1-0 now. Swings, hits this one in the air down the right field line. One away. Time for the offensive lineup for Tony La Russa. Thoughts, John? Anybody stand out?
Albert Pujols, Gary, you know, he's a guy that he'll take a walk if you're going to walk him, but if you make a mistake, he gives him one pitch to hit, he's going to hit it out of the ballpark. Great contact hitter also, drives in a lot of runs with ground ball outs.
The Reds defensively are going to look like this. Second base. The 0-0 delivery, a fastball taken for a strike.
Now guys, you know, the fact the Cardinals are atop that division just about year after year, they have a bullseye on their back, and the Reds certainly had them targeted early in the season.
And they don't want to forget about him over there, but he's back easily. This one's pretty well hit to deep left center. That's the second out of the runner on his way to third. Cardinals have to be a little disappointed, Steve, that within their own division, they were only .500.
You know, they beat up on Cincinnati pretty well. They swept them a series in August, ended up taking the lead. On August 12th, they had a one-game lead, 15 games over .500. But they played sub-500 baseball the rest of the season, finished six games behind in the division.
Two outs and a runner on third. Taps this one foul off to the left. The pitch. Missed with the fastball outside, and it's even at one.
Well, you watch how the hitter reacted to that. He had thoughts about chasing that pitch, but at the last second decided to lay off of it.
A line drive towards the hole, and the sides retired as they head into the dugout. They get a man to third, but can't bring him home. Cincinnati, they're maintaining their advantage. Another chance for the leadoff hitter coming up in the inning. Playing under some nice weather today, at least cool weather. Still need to keep those pitching hands warmed up, though. The pitch. Starts him out with a slider for a strike. Called strike on a fastball, and it's 0-2. Foul straight back. Swung ground ball to short. Picked by Smith. In time for the out. Here's how the Central Division race is shaping up in late April, courtesy of State Farm. First place, the Cubs. The Reds, second place. The Brewers, third place. Pirates in fourth place. In the fifth hole, it's the Cardinals. And wrapping up the list, the Astros. Larkin is batting. One out, nobody on. He makes contact, line drive. And that's by him into center, base hit.
It's nice to get that runner on base with one out. Good piece of hitting that single. Now they got something to work with.
Rose up now. He singled and later scored in his last time up. One down, runner at first. First pitch on the way. Slider's in there for a called strike.
But Gary, slider's such an effective pitch, and it's this guy's put-away pitch. When he needs the big out, that's where he's going to go.
Here's the pitch. Looks at a fastball in there, and it's quickly 0-2.
Here, you know, we talk about his slider. What makes it so effective is that break, that depth and width to the pitch. It goes through two planes, so it's tough to center.
Ball one. Good slider that time. Ruled the ball. 1-2.
Good spot there. Just down a little bit out of the zone. Tried to get him to chase. He wouldn't go for it.
The 1-2 on its way. On the ground to second. And he's up with it. That's one. And they get it. They turn two. So no runs on one hit and nobody left on. Cincinnati 2. St. Louis nothing. Albert Pujols at the plate. His lifetime average, .356 against the Reds. Swings and misses. The sinker, 0-1. He swings and nails a liner. And that gets down. Pujols picks up the base hit.
Well, let's take a look at Albert Pujols and how last season stacked up. First in home runs, first in RBIs, and the willingness to take the base on balls. He was willing to take that walk when they gave it to him, not being selfish and trying to swing to force things and make them happen.
Mize is the batter. Runner on first, no outs. Can't wait long enough for that one, and he starts out with a strike.
Credit the catcher on that one. That's a good low target setting up, and he hit the target. Good execution.
The pitch. Here's a sinker that misses. 1-1. Strike Good downward action on that sinker. 1-2.
Well, he got a little over anxious on that last sinker and swings and misses.
Foul! And he swings and hits this one foul. That one swung on its line. That one gets through for a base hit. This a great situation for some offense.
He takes this 1-2 pitch down in the zone. He's able to go down and get it, get a good part of the bat on the ball, and pick up the base hit.
That's a tough pitch to hit when you're behind in the count. You just want contact, and he got it. It's going to be Boyer. Runners at first and second. Nobody out. Off the plate with a fastball, and it's 1-0. Here's the 1-0. That one's drilled to short. Gets one at second. And two. They pull off the double play. And a great throw right there. Second base, strong arm.
Arm strength critical, turning the double play. It can be a matter of a split second to get the out. Great double play.
And something to look forward to this Tuesday. The Seattle Mariners will be on the road. They'll be in Detroit to take on the Tigers. Game time is 1 p.m. Eastern, 10 Pacific. Man on third, two outs. That curve is just a little bit outside. One ball, no strikes. That's it. Pretty well down the line and left. This two-run homer ties the game. A clutch piece of hitting.
Well, he looked like he got the pitch in his wheelhouse, and he just drove it out of the ballpark.
When you get behind in a ball game, you want to get back early, get your mental set back, and they've done that.
Now, this inning isn't over yet. They have a chance to still tack on some more runs. Well, now that the Cardinals have been able to tie up the game, let's see if they can't keep on some pressure, add on some more runs, and try to get out in front here, Gary.
Base is empty with two outs. Ball throws one. That curveball a little low, ball one. Steve, this kind of home run to tie a game, you get it late, everybody's standing, you were hoping for it. You kind of hope, I guess, you're not hoping for it this early, but they got it.
No, but they're showing they can match, you know, swing for swing what the other team's doing, so it can make a big difference.
It's now one ball, one strike. You watch that fastball that was in there.
A good four-seam fastball right there. You have to know yourself. He didn't think he could catch up to it. Better off to take it.
Ground ball to short. And another. Wow, that hitting coach is smiling.
Let's take a look last year in the National League where the Cardinals ended up ranking. Second in batting average. Second in batting average with runners in scoring position. And they were ranked third in hits, a team that could put the bat on the ball and find their ways to get on base.
And in the batter's box, it's Braun. He doubled in his last appearance. Two outs and a man on first. The first pitch. And they pitch out. Nobody's moving. The 1-0 pitch. He fouls that one off.
Foul!
Here's a called strike on the outer half, and it's 1-2.
A good sinking movement on that pitch right on the black away from the hitter. Tough pitch to hit.
Pitch on the way. Curveball. Ooh, where did that miss? 2-2.
The best curveballs are the ones that start in the strike zone, then fall out of the strike zone. He couldn't get him to fish for that one, though.
Popped way up there behind home plate. That one's grabbed. Side retired. They come up with two runs to pull even. We're tied up here in St. Louis. And Joe Morgan to bat. Had a base hit his last time up. First pitch. Fastball just misses. 1-0. Fastball swung on. Couldn't connect. 1-1. Here's the delivery. There's a swing and a line drive. Gets down. The go-ahead runs on base. Now a look at the teams who generated the most runs last year, courtesy of State Farm. The Reds, number one. The Phillies in second. The Rockies, third. Fourth, the Brewers. And number five, the Braves, rounded out.
Well, when this team steps on the field, it's like a track meet. It seems like every one of these guys wants that ability to hit home plate. Seems like almost every game. They led the league last year in runs scored, and this is a team that has so much team speed and power that that's why they are so successful at plating runs.
Here's the first pitch. This one's grounded near third. Foul. Here goes Morgan. He's running. And it's not in time, and he beats the throw. Checks him at second. Foul fastball. Now the count 1-2.
Well, the hitter lays off this one and takes the strike, realizing not a pitch he wants in this situation.
One-two pitch coming.
Ball two.
And he watches that one travel down. 2-2.
If you're going to miss, this is where you want to miss. Throw that breaking ball at the bottom of the strike zone. If the hitter swings and puts it in play, it's a ground ball out.
And he's running on the move for third. Swing and a miss on the slider. One out. Over to third. He is safe. They tried to get the double play starting at third. It won't work.
Well, credit the pitcher right there. Good two-strike pitch down and away. Not much he could have done with that, even if he had made contact. Now, rank-wise, let's take a moment to see how the Reds are doing this year. First in ERA, fifth in home runs. And they're in the top 10 in base on balls, and a real strength for any club that even if you're not hitting on a given day, if you work the count, you can get runners on and get base runners in scoring position.
One out with a runner at third. First pitch to him. First pitch, a slider for a called strike.
I don't think he liked that call very much, but the reality is he couldn't hit that any day of the week. That's a great pitch.
He lets that fastball go by for a called strike, 0-2.
Tough spot for the hitter right here, down 0-2. You got to foul off that tough pitch if you have to.
Wanted to get him fishing, but he misses 1-2. The 1-2 pitch. Ball. Slider tough to lay off, and it's 2-2. At the belt, here's the 2-2 pitch. Fastball is low that time. The count runs full.
Boy, it's a great fastball right there, down in the strike zone. Now there's so many ways to go. Let's see how he comes back to attack this hitter.
The 3-2 pitch. And that missed, ball four. He'll put the double play in order, though, with one away.
A good eye by the hitter. He was waiting on the fastball in the 3-2 count. That's what he was looking for. It was out of the zone. Take your base.
Number 9 spot at the plate again. He's 1-for-1 so far. Runners at first and third. One away. And the first pitch. Slider just misses. 1-0. Ready with a 1-0. 1-0 pitch is a slider. Swung on and missed. 1-1.
Well, you see that pitch coming in, and it starts at the center of the plate. And all of a sudden, as soon as you start your swing, that's when that slider starts breaking away, gets out of the strike zone away. He can't stop his swing and swings and misses.
The 1-1. Swung on, grounded towards the hole. And Morgan comes home.
Well, the pitcher left us one over the middle part of the plate, right where the hitter can make contact. Good piece of hitting.
Boy, with a run scoring there, that's a pretty fat pitch in an RBI situation.
Keep the rally going.
And the first baseman in. And, Steve, they've got the edge right now. They're getting some big runs at an important part of the game, trying to salt it away early.
That was a good piece of hitting right there. He got his pitch, took advantage of it, drove it, and picked up the run.
Runners on first and second with one out. First pitch on the way. There's a swing and a liner towards first. Pujols for one. On to second. Safe there, so they get the one out. So, our State Farm leaderboard to look at the teams who hit best with runners in scoring position last year. Number one, the Reds. Second, the Cardinals. In third, the Rockies. Fourth, D-backs. For the Padres, they are in that 5 spot.
Well, you absolutely love doing a game like this. Two of the more clutch-hitting teams in the league last season. These guys love hitting with runners in scoring position. And the thing is, it's not just one guy. It's the whole team. These guys love it. They like getting guys on base, and they love bringing them in. They're going to make the pitchers work extremely hard in this one.
Here's the 1-0. Hot shot towards the hole. And he'll step on first to retire the side. So they pick up a run on two hits, and they leave a couple. Cincinnati leading now. They have got the momentum. It'll be batters 2 through 4 due up next. And Ozzie Smith in. And Smith in the batter's box. First pitch.
Ball.
Too low on that one for a ball. 1-0. 1-0 on the way. And misses below the knees, ball two.
Wow, he had some good bite on that one right there. But the hitter wouldn't chase it.
And that one misses outside, ball three.
Now, if you got a chance to see the last game, you saw he seemed a little bit flustered at the plate, expanding the strike zone, striking out twice in that game.
Lost in ball four. Potential tying run is on.
He didn't give him anything to hit at all. Free pass on four pitches.
Hornsby is the batter.
Oh, Gary, that walk right there is the tying run in this game. That's not how you want to make the opposition do it. Make them earn it.
Runner on first base, nobody out. And here's the first one. Big swing and a miss. Strike one. Steve, he knows he's really got a pitch now. He's put himself in a situation where he's really brought pressure on himself.
These are the type of innings you get really big on you right here. It's about damage control. I know you put the tying run out, but you've got to bear down right here.
Here's the delivery. 0-1 is a sinker in there. Called strike.
This pitcher being very aggressive throwing strikes. I think he's going to try to get him to chase.
On the way. And he's out. He goes down swinging on a pitch that was in the dirt. Down on strikes there. Nice piece of pitching work.
He threw the sinker ball out of the zone and got the hitter to chase it for a strikeout. You need better plate discipline than that.
And we've got Musial batting. Lined out in his last at bat. Smith on first. First pitch on the way.
Strike one!
Ball! Missed badly with a fastball there, 1-1.
Well, you saw the catcher right there setting up inside, and the pitcher just missed off the plate. Still a pretty good pitch, though.
Pitch out. Nothing was on, though. The 2-1 pitch. Fastball on the block. He doesn't get the call, though, and it's 3-1.
Well, this is your dream when you're in the on-deck circle before you go into the batter's box. If you can get the count to 3-1 and in your favor, you know you have the upper hand.
He set the 3-1.
Ball four.
And that misses. Ball four. The potential tying run in scoring position.
He went with a fastball and a three-ball count, which is what you want to do most often. He just couldn't throw a strike.
That's going to bring up Albert Pujols.
Well, with a rich history in Major League Baseball, the St. Louis Cardinals, where do you put Albert Pujols on the all-time list of great Cardinals?
One out with runners at first and second. Now bench sets up. Just off the outside, and it's 1-0.
Well, certainly a good question, John, where he'll rate as a Cardinal, but certainly even if you put the pitchers in with the all-time great hitters they've had, he's right there at the top and maybe number one when he's done.
Yeah. I mean, here's the thing. I think where you can talk about rating with the Cardinals, the question is where is he in the all-time greats in the history of the game? He'll be the best player they'll have ever had, and he may end up being the best right-handed hitter to ever play the game.
Here's the pitch. A smash towards the hole. A prime chance for production for the Cardinals.
Well, this is great patience at the plate. He lets the ball get deep in on the plate, comes in toward his hands, keeps his hands inside the ball, and drives it the other way.
You make yourself a whole different ball player if you can take the ball the other way, as he just did.
Bases are loaded here with only one away. Here's the first pitch. Swing sends this one on the line to right center. Ace hit, run should come in. It'll be a tie game. And he scores. That is the tying run. He comes in to score, and they're going to get the lead. And he's on board. Credit him with two RBIs on the base hit. So look now at the win expectancy graph and what those two RBIs have done to their chances. And Steve, the offense continues to produce. They keep building on it. Two men on, one out. Here's the first pitch. Sinker drops in for a called strike. A win yesterday for the Reds. This three-game series going their way right now. A win here, and they'll have a three-game sweep against the Cardinals. He deals. Swing and a miss, and he's behind on the count 0-2. The offense got busy for them. It came a little late last four innings, but it worked.
Well, they got stifled early in the game, but these guys are such great hitters, they came through late and helped preserve this win.
Now Bench positions himself. That'll be a base hit at an RBI. Situations repeating themselves here. A chance to produce, and they are.
Okay, the defense needs to stop right now. They need to put up an out here. This offense just has been relentless this evening.
Runners on first and second with one out. And the first pitch. Sinker just missed, 1-0.
Wow, he had some good bite on that one right there, but the hitter wouldn't chase it.
Pauses, and now the 1-0. And he looks at a fastball in there, 1-1.
Well, third inning of this ballgame, Gary, clearly he's run into a little bit of a brick wall and up over 20 pitches right here.
Sinker that time misses, 2-1.
Well, this is a good situation right here for the offensive team. A fast runner on first base and a guy with the head in the count, 2-1. Good time for a hit and run.
Up the middle. Whoa, get out of the way of that one. Straight back up the middle. And two, a double play. They pick up three here on three hits and strand one. St. Louis taking the lead and putting the heat on. We'll be looking to the leadoff batter later on in this inning, another AB. Sixth slot up at the plate again. 0-1 thus far. Here it comes. Plays off a called strike of the knees, 0-1.
Some guys really like the low fastball. In this situation, though, he ends up taking the pitch.
Here's the pitch. Hard ground and a short. And his throw is in time for out number one. These teams set the tone in offense last year. Let's take a look. Brought to you by State Farm. Number one, the Reds. The Phillies in second. In third, the Rockies. Fourth, the Brewers. And number five, the Braves rounded out.
But when this team steps on the field, it's like a track meet. It seems like every one of these guys wants that ability to hit home plate. Seems like almost every game. They led the league last year in runs scored, and this is a team that has so much team speed and power that that's why they are so successful at plating runs.
Now the 1-0 pitch. Fastball just misses, and he falls behind 2-0.
Well, anytime you have a good fastball and you can keep it down in the zone around the knees or lower, it's great location and, believe me, very difficult to hit.
Misses low, ball three.
A lot of managers are hesitant to turn their guys loose 3-0, but I say let it fly. This might be the best pitch he sees in the whole at bat.
That misses ball four. Now we're going to see if we'll get some motion on the base pass.
Off the plate outside, he's missed on four straight. He's got to bring it back in the zone.
Now, it's still early on in the new baseball season for Cincinnati. Here's where they sit in the rankings in the National League. Fifth in home runs, eighth in stolen bases, and they're in the top 10 in team batting average. That depth and length of the lineup paying big dividends for this team as they seem to find ways to get base hits.
First pitch on the way. And that finds the outside corner for strike one.
This is the go-to pitch for many pitchers in the major league. The fastball down and away. When in doubt, that's where you go.
Ball. Oh, and he lays off the fastball. Good pitch, 1-1. He takes off for second.
Ball two.
And he's in there at second base. Here's the 2-1. 2-1 delivery of fastball. Taken for a call. Strike two. Fastball is low that time. The count runs full.
Well, that fastball right there just missed, just below the knees. Tell you what, a borderline pitch. I think they wanted that one bad.
The full count pitch. Full count. That misses ball four. The potential tying run on base.
Well, the hardest thing to do when you have an at-bat that lasts this long is sometimes you have a tendency to be impatient and chase one. Give the hitter a lot of credit. It was a close pitch, but he laid off of it to earn that walk.
Morgan at the plate.
That walk is the tying run in this situation. Now he's got to look for a ground ball, try to get the double play and get out of this inning.
One out with runners at first and second. First pitch, here it comes. Fastball just misses, 1-0. Steve, you issue walks, as has happened here in this inning. You limit now what you can do. You got to get the guys out, not let anybody else on.
Well, that's right. He's going to have to look for a ball down in the zone, try to get the hitter hit on top of it and get that double play.
The 1-0 now. That's a called strike on the outer half, 1-1. Swings for a strike on the fastball. It'll be a 1-2 count.
Well, climbing the ladder on him right there. He just throws that fastball right by him up in the zone.
Foul!
That one goes foul. Checks him at second. Didn't look like he was going to go anywhere that time, so he's easily back. Here's the delivery. Swing and a miss on the fastball, second out in the inning.
Two outs now. Those runners are still standing on base. Let's see if he can find his way out of this with the lead intact.
Here's how the Central Division race is shaping up in late April, courtesy of State Farm. First place, the Cubs. In the second spot, it's the Reds. The Brewers, third place. Pirates in fourth place. In the fifth hole, it's the Cardinals. And wrapping up the list, the Astros. Two men on and two men out. And the first pitch. Swings and misses the slider, 0-1.
I think we're going to see the catcher call for a lot of sliders in this one, Gary. He's got a good one, and hitters just have not been able to figure it out.
Here's the pitch. Hit hard to second. Hornsby throws on to first in time to retire the side. So they can't push any across here in this half of the inning. St. Louis 5, Cincinnati 3. A crisp day here at the ball yard. Temperatures might be dropping a bit later on towards the evening. Number 16 coming in to hurl as they make the pitching swap. Here's the pitch. Lays off the changeup. Good pitch, but it's 1-1.
Well, he tried to change up right there, but it just stayed down and off the plate.
Swing and a miss and a ball tailing down. 1-2.
Well, he clearly fooled him right there. He had him thinking fastball, and he pulled the string on it, got him to swing right through it.
He sends this one in the air towards center. That's one down. And a quick look at how Cincinnati's schedule is shaping up. St. Louis series wraps up today. The road trip continues. They face some good competition. The Milwaukee Brewers will be hosting. That'll be Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. And then the Marlins come into town, kicking off a homestand. Boy, there's some great competition in that set of games. Wins will not come easy over the next stretch of games. And in the batter's box, it's Braun. Popped out at foul territory last time. One out, base is empty. The first pitch. Watches that fastball. That goes by him for a strike.
The pitcher showing that he can effectively throw strikes in the inside part of the plate. The hitter now has to make an adjustment, possibly opening up for that pitch next time.
That's low and outside, 1-1. Good spot for the changeup that time, 1-2. Here's the pitch.
Ball!
Inside for a ball. We're even at two.
Well, you saw the catcher right there setting up inside, and the pitcher just missed off the plate. Still a pretty good pitch, though.
And this is inside, and that hit him hard.
I think it's safe to say, Gary, that's going to leave a mark. That hurts from up here.
And Ozzie Smith in.
Well, Gary, as we saw that hitter get hit with the pitch right there, it's just a mechanical issue. He'll get that ironed out a little bit, but I don't think it's intentional, certainly.
One out, runner on at first. And Smith in the batter's box, first pitch. First pitch, a fastball, that's in there for a strike. And now we'll see if he can regroup here, get control of that pitch again, see how willing he is to throw it again right away.
Well, what you don't want to do is let it get in your head when you start to worry about pitching inside or getting too close to anybody. So he's got to make sure his head's right.
Now bench sets up. This one swung on line softly to third. And Smith's got himself a single. Can't cut it off. It's going to roll to the wall. Fantastic chance here. 0-2 count, so you protect the pitch that's up. It's a little easier to do that.
Absolutely. You can fight it off, punch it over the infielder's head. That time, solid piece of hitting.
Runners on first and second with one out. Spins, checks him at second. One out with runners at first and second. First pitch on the way. Fastball misses away. 1-0.
Well, you can see what he's doing. He's just pulling that ball away from him, trying to overthrow it, and he can't seem to find the strike zone. He has to be able to rein that thing in right now.
And he's back in, standing up. Pitch on the way. 1-0 delivery is a fastball in there. 1-1.
Looks like the hitter's waiting for a pitch that he can get up in the zone to drive a little bit. That's why he went down to the zone with that four-seamer.
Swinging and a miss, and it's now 1-2.
Credit the catcher on that one. That's a good low target setting up, and he hit the target. Good execution.
Trying to get him to chase the fastball away. 2-2. And this is bounced foul to the left side. Now the 2-2. And he fouls off another one.
Well, this is one of these at-bats that you know you want to get something to drive. The bottom line is, though, the pitcher is not giving you anything to hit in a gap. So you're being defensive and fouling things off. This is a great battle right here.
Well, he finished that one off with a strikeout. Nice pitch.
He's got a shot of getting out of this now. Big timeout. Now he's got two down. He's only one out away from working out of this jam.
League leaders in on-base percentage last year, courtesy of State Farm. There you see Pujols in the second spot. Third is Prince Fielder. Joey Votto, number one.
Well, there's no more valuable player in the lineup than a guy who can get on base and get on base often. And this guy's one of the best at it in baseball. He has so many different ways he can get on base. The thing is, he makes the pitcher work so much harder that you don't see a lot of starting pitchers finishing games against his team because of his ability to work counts.
Checks him at second. And here's the pitch.
Ball one.
Missed with the fastball outside, and it's even at one. The double steal is on.
Ball.
Oh, man, the double steal worked as he beat the throw. The 2-1 pitch. That's off the plate away. 3-1.
Well, you've got to be careful right here. Look, you're down in the count 3-1. You just can't throw something in there and hope he gets himself out. This guy's too dangerous for that.
He set the 3-1.
Strike two.
Strike two. The 3-2 pitch. Fouled off.
Foul ball!
The 3-2 pitch. Fastball swung on and missed. Side retired. Well, they pick up no runs, one hit, and strand a couple. And it'll be the Reds coming up next. And Foster's in the box. He'll get a start here in the fifth. First pitch. First pitch is a slider low, 1-0.
Now, if you're going to miss, this is where you want to miss. Throw that breaking ball at the bottom of the strike zone. If the hitter swings and puts it in play, it's a ground ball out.
Here's the 1-0. Next pitch misses high for ball two. Here's the delivery. He waves at that fastball, 2-1. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Now here's a grounder towards the hole. And that's out number one as he takes it to the bag. And here's what's happening this Tuesday. We'll see Miguel Cabrera and the Detroit Tigers. They'll be hosting the Seattle Mariners. That will kick off at 1 p.m. Eastern. One out, nobody on. And here's the first one. There's a swing and a line drive. Two retired here.
That ball was hit so hard, the second baseman barely had time to react, but playing in the right spot, he gets the out.
And the number seven batter in the box. Big things can happen anytime he steps in that batter's box. Number three slot up again here. Lined out last time up. Two outs and nobody on. Here's the first pitch.
Ball.
And Carpenter outside the strike zone with that one. The pitch. Swung on, lined over the first baseman's head. And it is in there. That's going to bring the tying run to the plate.
Well, we've got a moment to look back to last year's Cincinnati Reds and see where they ranked in the National League. First in batting average. First in batting average with runners in scoring position. They were also ranked number one in hits, a lineup with depth that can make contact and find their way to base.
It's going to be Perez now. 0 for 2 thus far. Two outs and a man on first. First pitch to him.
Ball.
Ugly pitch. Catcher able to somehow scoop that out. And here's Carpenter's 1-0 pitch. In there at the letters, evening the count at 1-1. One curveball misses, 2-1.
Well, you want to start this pitch outside. The curveball is better when it's away from the hitter to break out of the zone, but it never had a chance of being a strike.
The pitch.
Ball.
Fastball gets away from him there, and it's 3-1.
Well, even though you're 3-1 in the count, you still have to be patient at the plate. Make him throw a quality pitch. If he does, be ready for it. And if you're the pitcher, you better not throw anything down the middle and hope he's taking it, because he can take you out of the yard.
Lost him, ball four. Potential tying run is on.
He went with a fastball in a 3-ball count, which is what you want to do most often. He just couldn't throw a strike.
Cleanup man in the box again.
Now, two outs in the inning, you put the tying run on base with a base on balls. Not what you want to do, because that also means the guy at the plate is the go-ahead run. Big mistake.
Two down. Runners at first and second. Now the first pitch. Hit in the air to left center. And that one's put away to retire the side. They pick up no runs on a hit, and they leave 2-1. St. Louis not letting their lead go. Albert Pujols at the plate. Over the course of last year, a 317 average against the Reds. First pitch to Pujols. That's hit foul by Pujols.
Foul!
Here's the pitch. That one swung on, hit in the air. No problem with that one.
Let's take a look last year in the National League where the Cardinals ended up ranking. Second batting average with runners in scoring position, and they were ranked third in hits, a team that could put the bat on the ball and find their ways to get on base.
Mize is the batter. He had a two-run single in his last appearance. Base is empty, one out. And the first pitch. Swings, hits this one pretty well. Deep right center. The catch, and he has it for the second out.
Well, I followed the scouting reports. They moved the outfielders back before the play, and they were in exactly the right position to be able to make the catch. Good coaching.
Space is empty. Here it comes.
Ball.
First pitch fastball. Misses badly that time. 1-0. Swung on. Liner to right. And it gets down. That's hit number two, making good contact.
Let's take a moment here to see where the Cardinals sit in the National League. Fourth in walks. Fourth in ERA, and they also show up in the top five in triples, which really proves that this is a team that can.
It was a win the last time out for the Reds. They've been in control after winning game one of the three-game series against the Cardinals. First pitch, here it comes. Fouled away. On the way. Hit hard to second. Picked up by Morgan. Throws to first, side is retired. No runs on a base hit. They leave one man on at first. St. Louis 5, Cincinnati 3. A crisp day here at the ball yard. Temperatures might be dropping a bit later on towards the evening. And here's the first one. Shot back to first, and it is in there. That's going to bring the tying run to the plate. Here's what's happening this Friday. Going to be Indians baseball at Progressive Field. The Detroit Tigers come into town. You can watch all the action starting at 4 o'clock Eastern. Rose batting now, walked in his last plate appearance.
With good speed now at first base, Gary, they're going to have to at least keep an eye on him. Even though they've got the lead, they've got to watch him because they might try to steal to get back into this game.
And Pujols, he's trying to keep him close over there. There's a swing, line drive, center field. And that gets the tying run on board. This is a great situation for some offense.
While most hitters love that ball elevated so they can try to hit it out of the ballpark, but this is not one of these hitters. He loves the ball down in the strike zone. That's why he got that big knock right there.
No one out yet. Runners at first and second. First pitch to him. And Carpenter gets him swinging for the first strike.
Oh, what an effective pitch. That two-seam fastball had him way out in front of it.
Down the center of the strike zone, and he's in the hole 0-2.
Well, this starts out a strike, and it ends up a strike. You got to swing the bat.
Slider, too far inside. That'll back him away a little.
Well, you have to have quick reflexes at the plate. The hitter getting out of the way there showed his reflexes.
The 1-2 on its way. Swing, and that's going to be hit behind the plate. Slider, that's taken. Strike three, one away.
Well, that's a big first out of this inning. Now let's see if he can come back and get out of this thing unscathed. Well, we've got a moment to look back to last year's Cincinnati Reds and see where they ranked in the National League. First in batting average. First in batting average with runners in scoring position. And they were also ranked number one in hits, a lineup with depth that can make contact and find their way to base.
Runners on first and second with one out. Off-speed pitches in there for a called strike.
Well, the hitters are going to have to be ready for that long, arching curveball because he can locate that pitch and throw it at just about any time of the count for a strike.
Now Carpenter with the 0-1 pitch. Lays off the curveball. Good pitch, though, 1-1. Talk about him throwing it at any time, Steve. He'll do that on a pitch where he's trying to get a strikeout.
Well, he's made a career out of being able to throw that 12-6 curveball, and the only thing you can do, the only way you hit it, is to look for it. Otherwise, take it.
And he scores. Well, that pitch was upstairs. He went up there and got it.
A nice piece of hitting. Got up on top of that ball and drove it.
It was a difficult task to try to get back into a ball game at this point, but they're close. Runners on first and second with one out. Carpenter with the windup. A swing and a drive deep left center field, and it rebounds off the wall around third, heading home. And he scores from second base.
Well, pitcher making a mistake right here, leaving it right over the heart of the plate. He squares it up, drives it, good contact at the plate to drive in a run.
Most of those kind of pitches are going to get hit. That's an RBI knock. Up again there, DH. Steve, this lineup, wow, if they've been able to create some opportunities, they are executing. They've got it tied.
Well, he came up big in that critical situation, Gary. Good at bat right there. Now he's tied it up.
One out with runners at first and second. And here's the first one. Just missed that one for strike one. Just checking my contract, Steve. It says here I'm obligated to say this is a brand new ball game.
Since when do you follow what you're contractually obligated to say? And either way, momentum has shifted.
Ball. One one delivery, a fastball taken for a strike, 1-2.
Hitters have to have great balance and be prepared for the pitch away. If you open up even a little bit, you can't catch up to that four-seam fastball in the outside corner.
Popped way up there behind home plate. Tried to track that one down, but comes up empty. The 1-2 pitch. Back up the middle. And he's up with it. To second for one. And a deuce, a double play. And heading to the dugout, Chris Carpenter. Up next, Cardinals. This afternoon, some fans bundled up in their jackets, a little chilly. The pitch. First pitch, and he misses the fastball, strike one. It was a win the last time out for the Reds. They've been in control after winning game one of the three-game series against the Cardinals. Take something off that time, in control with the count now, 0-2. The last four innings of that last game making a world of difference for the offense.
Well, did it ever, and those bats woke up late in the game to help seal the victory.
And that one gets popped way up behind the plate. That's one away.
Although we're not too far along in the baseball season, we're far enough into it to see where the Cardinals rank in the National League. Sixth in stolen bases, ninth in home runs, and the batting average numbers just not where this club would like them to be right now. Not enough contact, not enough depth in the lineup in production with these guys swinging the bat.
Bases empty with one away. Here's the first pitch. That's off the plate away, 1-0. On the way. And he takes a strike on that fastball, 1-1.
Sometimes you get a pitch, and if it's early enough in the count, you can just say, not this one, I'm going to wait for the next one.
Hard ground to short. Larkin. On to first, two away.
Let's take a look last year in the National League for where the Cardinals ended up ranking. Second in batting average. Second in batting average with runners in scoring position. And they were ranked third in hits, a team that could put the bat on the ball and find their ways to get on base.
And Ozzie Smith in.
Now, if you got a chance to see the last game, you saw he seemed a little bit flustered at the plate, expanding the strike zone, striking out twice in that game.
And Smith in the batter's box, first pitch.
Ball.
Just missed with the fastball, 1-0. He delivers.
Ball.
Fastball just misses, and he falls behind, 2-0.
Well, that right there is a really good pitch, just missing the outside corner. Give the batter a lot of credit, though. That is one of the toughest pitches to lay off of, that hard fastball away.
Ball.
Fastball misses high, and it's 3-0.
The pitcher can't find the zone right here, but I'm still giving my hitter the green light. I think he has enough discipline to get a good pitch and try to drive it.
And he lays it down. He'll try to beat it out. Ends up foul. And bench calls for the pitch. And that one is going to be outside. And that is ball four. And now you've got a base stealer on.
He went with a fastball and a three-ball count, which is what you want to do most often. He just couldn't throw a strike.
Hornsby gets a shot here.
Now, with two outs in the inning, you don't want to give a free pass. Make them earn it. As long as you keep it in the ballpark, it doesn't hurt you, but that walk can come back to haunt you.
A runner on first with two outs. First pitch on the way. Off the plate with a fastball, and it's 1-0. And with the walk surrendered as it was in the inning, you got to keep your composure now and not give in here.
Well, he certainly doesn't want to give up an extra base hit right now to allow that run to score, so the defense has got to be playing no doubles.
Oh, and Smith takes off.
Strike one!
And it's not in time, and he beats the throw. on the way.
Ball.
Good looking fastball. Called the ball though, 2-1.
We have to remember these middle relievers, they're not used to coming in and throwing over 45 pitches, but that's where he's at right now. You might see his control run away from him a little bit right here.
Here's the 2-1. Here's a swing and a high pop-up. And that's the third out. That'll do it. So they can't push any across here in this half of the inning. We're tied up here in St. Louis. Number 9 spot at the plate again. He'll lead off the 7th. And the first pitch. And Carpenter has him 0-1 with that called strike. Here's the pitch. 0-1 pitch is a change, swung on and missed, 0-2.
That changeup away is one of the most effective pitches because when the hitter's fooled, he starts to pull off the ball. He can only hit an inside pitch. He can't possibly reach the outside pitch unless he breaks down his swing.
Well, he finished that one off with a strikeout. Nice pitch.
It seemed like he made it easy. 3 pitches, big strikeout.
Can't get rid of a guy any quicker than that. Only took 3 and he's gone. Here's how the Central Division race is shaping up in late April, courtesy of State Farm. First place, the Cubs. The Reds, second place. Brewers in third place. The Pirates, fourth place. Cardinals in the 5th position. And wrapping up the list, the Astros. One out, bases empty. Here's the first pitch.
Ball.
Carpenter can't get him to swing at a pitch down low.
Well, hitters know those two-seam fastballs down on the way turn into ground ball out, so they lay off of it, but with 2 strikes, it's a pitch you have to swing at.
Ball two.
Fastball misses badly. He's behind 2-0. And here's a fastball for a called strike, 2-1.
He looked like he was ready to swing that time at the plate, Gary, but he must have been looking for a different pitch as that fastball just paints the outside corner.
Fastball on the black. He doesn't get the call, though, and it's 3-1.
Well, anytime you have a count 3-1 in your favor as the hitter, you're looking for a pitch in a little box in the location you want to. If he throws it in there, you better be ready and get a good hack at it.
Swung on, line to right center field. And it's starting to head out towards the wall. He's thinking extra bases. Now our State Farm leaderboard looking at the teams leading the league in slugging percentage from last year. The Reds, number 1. Second, the Rockies. Third spot, the Brewers. Fourth, D-backs. And number 5, the Phillies rounded out.
Well, Gary, we're going to see sluggers in this game today. And I tell you what, they got guys who can take you out of the ballpark, but they also hit a ton of extra base hits. So they keep double plays out of order. That's why they're so successful in that category.
And the first pitch. A swing line to left center. And he'll take an extra base on this one. It's rolling towards the wall. That's going to break the tie. They lead by 1.
Well, the pitcher left this one over the middle part of the plate, right where the hitter can make contact. Good piece of hitting.
Boy, with a run scoring there, that's a pretty fat pitch in an RBI situation.
Keep the rally going.
Larkin at the plate. Boy, we have seen this offense building momentum, Steve, and what a time of the ballgame to do it.
Well, they were given an opening, and they took it. And now they have a lead late in the game.
Man on second, 1 away. And the first pitch, swung on, lined over the first baseman's head. And another hit back-to-back. Can't cut it off. It's going to roll to the wall. And they score him. The throw. Oh, and he is safe. He just barely makes it home. Check out the wheels on this guy. You got to have those wheels if you're going to end up at home.
Well, there's no question about it, but you also need some help from the defense, and the defense had a letdown there that allowed an inside-the-park home run. Well, how can you argue with what Cincinnati's been doing right here? Good offensive approach. Now they've expanded the lead.
Base is empty with one away. Here's the delivery. Watches a fastball that's in there. 0-1. This game is not a done deal yet, but boy, when you get those kind of hits this late in a ball game, you're on your way probably to a W.
And now the manager's got to start thinking about, okay, my offense has gotten the job done. What's my bullpen going to do?
Hit in the air to center field. Two retired here. There's more MLB this Thursday. Going to be Indians baseball at Progressive Field. They'll be hosting the Kansas City Royals. You can tune in for live 12 noon Eastern action. Morgan at the plate. Base is empty with two outs. And here's the first one. Carpenter gets it by him.
Now the pitcher's executing his game plan. He knows these hitters. He knows how he wants to pitch them. And now he's locating his pitches in exactly the right spot.
Swung on, hit in the air to right center. And another hit. They're really gunning right now.
Now, rank-wise, let's take a moment to see how the Reds are doing this year. First in ERA, fifth in home runs, and they're in the top 10 in base on balls. And a real strength for any club that even if you're not hitting on a given day, if you work the count, you can get runners on and get base runners in scoring position. Now, with Morgan on and that kind of speed, he's a threat to steal a base.
Well, he's running, taking off for second. And he's in there at second base. Line towards second, and that's going to do it in this half inning. Boy, you talk about having to eat it up. That's what Chris Carpenter's gone through in the inning. Seventh inning stretch in St. Louis. And we've got Musial batting. 0-for-2 thus far. First pitch on the way. Up the middle. And you know something? This one deserves a second look.
Now we're going to be seeing that one over and over again on the highlight reels. Great heads-up play.
And it's Albert Pujols now with one away.
And guys, the amazing thing about Pujols is he will take a walk. He's not going to stretch out his strike zone in order to put the ball in play. He doesn't like to strike out. He does what's best for his team, and that's getting on base for the guys behind him.
First pitch to Pujols. That swung on, hit on the ground. And he steps on first. That's the second out. Here's a look at the teams who got it done last year at the plate. Brought to you by State Farm. Number one, the Reds. Second, the Cardinals. In third, the Rockies. Fourth, the Brewers. And number five, the Phillies rounded out.
Well, I wouldn't want to be a pitcher in this game, Gary. I mean, if you're looking to get through a bunch of quick innings, it might not happen in this one. Two of the better teams last season in the league in batting average. These guys have the ability to put the ball in play, and when they do, they usually get hits doing it. This is going to be a tough battle for these pitchers here today.
That's right down the chute, called strike.
Well, they need a big two-out rally right here. Try to see if you can't reduce this three-run lead a little bit. Leave yourself something to do in the eighth and ninth, but try to peck away at it right here.
Swung on and ripped towards second. Throws to first in time. That's three down. And they aren't able to make any noise here in this half inning. Cincinnati, 8. Cardinals, 5. And if you're just joining in, Gary Thorne with Steve Phillips and John Kruk bringing you Major League Baseball here on 2K Sports. Carpenter with the windup. First pitch fastball misses badly that time, 1-0. The 1-0 pitch. Lined right at the second baseman. That one's glove.
Well, we've got a moment to look back to last year's Cincinnati Reds and see where they ranked in the National League. First in batting average. First in batting average with runners in scoring position. They were also ranked number one in hits, a lineup with depth that can make contact and find their way to base.
And the number seven batter in the box. He hit into a double play as last time. One out, nobody on. Now the first pitch. Starts him out with a fastball for a strike.
Oh, that's a quality fastball right there. Just pounding the strike zone down and away. He had no chance to put that one in play.
Well, that's on the outside corner. Nothing in two.
You go with the big breaking ball away. It's exactly where you want to go. Set up hard in and go soft away. Nice pitch.
That misses at the shins, 1-2.
Well, anytime one of your middle relievers throws over 45 pitches, you got to wonder how much more he has left. Might want to get someone else up out there.
Here's the pitch. There's a swing and a liner. And the catch by Smith. Cleanup man in the box again. He's had one hit, four times up. Two outs and nobody on. And the first pitch. Lined up the middle. Makes its way through for a single. On tap for the Cardinals. This game, the last against Cincinnati. They'll be traveling tomorrow. They'll take on a division rival, National League Central. The Astros at Minute Maid Park. That's Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. And it's a road trip to take on the Braves and the always tough at-bat of Chipper Jones. Great series there. That's quite a few road games coming up, and that's always challenging. It's going to be Perez now. He doubled and scored in his last trip to the plate. Two outs and a man on first. He's running, heading for second. Throw, he is out. Great throw. No runs, one hit, and no one left on base. Now the Cardinals, home half of the eighth. It'll be the bottom third of the order coming to the plate. It's going to be Boyer. He'll get us started as we go to the bottom half of the eighth inning. Here's the first pitch. Fastball taken high, 1-0.
Obviously getting late right now, Gary, and
I think that from the pitching perspective, you'll trade an out for a run at this stage of the game, understanding that for every out you get, you're closer to winning.
Here's the 1-0. This is in the air, straight away left. And he makes the catch, one down. Here's what Cincinnati has lined up. St. Louis series wraps up today. And then on the road for a series against the Brewers as they get help from Corey Hart in that lineup. That series bound to be competitive. That'll be a three-game series. Continuing on, they'll square off against some good competition. The Florida Marlins. So some difficult days ahead for them. Nobody on base. One away. First pitch on the way. Here's a swing and a liner to left center. And in there, second hit for him in the ballgame in his fourth plate appearance.
Now he's a first pitch fastball hitter. He got the fastball and ripped it into left.
And we got McGee batting. We'll try it again here, just 1-for-3 thus far. Runner at first with one down. Here's the pitch. Change up just misses. 1-0.
Well, that pitch right there, that change up away. If a guy's looking for it, that's a great pitch to be able to hit the other way with some power.
The 1-0 now. It's now one ball, one strike. You watch that fastball that was in there.
Well, the hitter lays off this one and takes the strike, realizing not a pitch he wants in this situation.
And here's a swing and a miss. He couldn't get that one. 1-2. One-two pitch coming. Change up that time. Swings and misses. That'll be strike 3-2 down.
That's about as straight as a string right there at 84 miles per hour.
Nice pitch on the inside corner. That gets him fishing a little bit.
Well, he wanted that one. You could see it in his body language. He just got outdueled by the pitcher on that one.
And in the batter's box, it's Braun. Runner on first, two away. And here's the first one. Swing and ooh, look out. Line drive that shatters the bat. Save your arm. Do it by pitching only 8 times in 1 inning, 3 outs. Reds holding on to the lead. Latter third of the lineup coming up. For those of you just coming on board, Gary Thorne with Steve Phillips and John Kruk, bringing you Major League Baseball on 2K Sports. Here's the first pitch. And Carpenter has him 1-1 with that called strike.
Well, you go with the big breaking ball away. It's exactly where you want to go. Set up hard in and go soft away. Nice pitch.
Here's the pitch. He lets that fastball go by for a called strike, 0-2.
The key for any pitcher is establishing the four-seam fastball. Once you get that working, it gives you so many different options.
Swung on and fouled away.
Ball!
Here's the delivery.
Ball!
Fastball is a waste pitch that time. 1-2. The 1-2 on its way. Slider called third strike, out number one.
Good chance to take a look at this slider right here, Gary.
Got him looking on a breaking ball.
A pitch that moves like that is something that is very useful to a pitcher if he's throwing it with confidence. And you can see that what a weapon that is.
Up again now, the number 5 spot. Not an RBI double this last time. Base is empty, one out. First pitch.
Ball.
And he lays off that pitch upstairs, ball one. Here's the 1-0.
Ball two.
Lost the grip to that changeup, and it's 2-0. Now the 2-0. He looks at that fastball. Called strike. 2-1.
Well, he's got a good four-seam fastball with good riding action to it, but he finds the heart of the plate here. Unfortunately for the hitter, he didn't swing.
Here he comes. 2-1 pitch. 2-1 pitch, a fastball. Outside. 3-1.
Well, this is your dream when you're in the on-deck circle before you go into the batter's box. If you can get the count to 3-1 and in your favor, you know you have the upper hand.
Pitch on the way. Hit up the middle.
Well, anytime you can get a guy on base who can steal bases, it puts so much pressure on the opponent. Let's see if they can get him around to score a run.
Now our State Farm sponsored look at which teams went the yard most last year. The Reds, number one. Second, the Brewers. Third, the D-backs. The Rockies, fourth. And number five, the Phillies rounded out.
Well, a lot of times they say that power hitters can be pitched to if you pitch them carefully. The problem is with this team, they have a ton of power hitters in this lineup. Number one in baseball last year in the home run. And you make a mistake, and everyone in this lineup can make you pay with the long ball.
Well, Gary, you can look at it a couple ways. You can say, look, we've got the lead. Let's play for another big hit here. Or you can turn it on, put the pedal to the metal, and keep the offense going. I want to see them run. I think this is the time to get them going.
0-1 is a slider for a call strike.
The hitter now needs to protect the plate. Think about going right back up the middle.
The pitch.
Ball.
Good slider that time. Ruled the ball. 1-2.
Now if you're going to miss, this is where you want to miss. Throw that breaking ball at the bottom of the strike zone. If the hitter swings and puts it in play, it's a ground ball out.
Curveball. Ooh, where did that miss? 2-2. Holds off on that slider, and it's 3-2.
When you throw a breaking ball like this, you want to start it on the corner and break it off the zone, trying to get the hitter to chase. The hitter didn't take the bait here.
The 3-2 pitch. That misses, ball four. Now we're going to see if we'll get some motion on the base paths.
Well, the hardest thing to do when you have an at-bat that lasts this long is sometimes you have a tendency to be impatient and chase one. Give the hitter a lot of credit. It was a close pitch, but he laid off of it to earn that walk.
Rose is batting. Last time up, flew out. Rose up now, had a couple of hits, four trips to the plate. Runners on first and second with one out. First pitch to him. Swing and a shot down the left field line. Rolling into the corner, that's going to be extra bases. And he will score from second base. Another run comes in right behind him. And he'll stop at second base. That'll be a two-run double.
Well, that big lead just got a little bit bigger, and I have to think this one's just about over.
And Joe Morgan to bat. Steve, we've seen them continue to charge it up at the plate, and it doesn't look like they're going to be stopped.
Well, they keep tacking on runs right here, extending the lead. That's a big hit now. They're cashing in, adding on to this lead.
They've got the engines running. This is pull-away time. Isringhausen gets set and delivered. He makes contact, line drive. And so Morgan retired. And Bench settles in. Lined out last time up. Two outs and a runner on second. First pitch on the way. Cutter just misses. 1-0.
That's a good pitch with a cut fastball. When you're throwing this pitch, you want to start it on the corner, run it off the plate, trying to get the hitter to chase. Good piece of hitting to lay off of it.
Strike one.
Good moving cutter, and it's 1-2 now.
That cut fastball just ran inside on the hitter's hands. He had no chance to even get out and swing at it. Tough pitch.
Isringhausen winds up 1-2.
Ball two.
Fastball just about had him, and it's a 2-2 count. Cutter just about frozen, but it's full now.
That's a good pitch with a cut fastball. When you're throwing this pitch, you want to start it on the corner, run it off the plate, trying to get the hitter to chase. Good piece of hitting to lay off of it.
Full count pitch. A swing and a fly ball to left center field. And he's there to retire the side. They score two runs, two hits, one left on. Cincinnati out in front by five. It'll be batters 2 through 4 due up next. And if you are just coming on board, Gary Thorne, Steve Phillips, John Kruk, as we bring you Major League Baseball here on 2K Sports. Smash towards the middle, and that'll retire Smith. One away.
Obviously, winning big right now, you just want to go out there, make plays, throw strikes, force them to try to put multiple hits together to get back into this game.
One out, nobody on. The first pitch. And he holds off on the pitch low, 1-0.
Flat fastball right there, just missed, just below the knees. Tell you what, a borderline pitch. I think they wanted that one bad.
Here's the delivery. He watches that fastball. It'll even up the count at 1-1.
A good life on this fastball as he just buries it down and away.
One pitch. Swing, hot shot. That should be a base hit.
Well, you're going to have to keep a close eye on this guy at first base. Pay a lot of attention to him because you know he more than likely has the green light. He can go at any time.
One out, man on first. He deals. Fastball runs inside, 1-0.
Well, this guy's really eating up some innings for this team. He's over the 60-pitch mark right now. And I tell you what, that's a lot of pitches for a middle relief pitcher.
Hit hard on the ground to short. There's one. Over to first and safe. Very close play. They will not get the double play. Runner on first now for Albert Pujols. Over the course of last year, a .317 average against the Reds. First pitch to Pujols. Fastball too low, 1-0.
Well, anytime you have a good fastball and you can keep it down in the zone around the knees or lower, it's great location and, believe me, very difficult to hit.
The 1-0 pitch. Swinging a liner to left. That's going to be a wrap. Final out of the ballgame.
Cincinnati showed up to play today, played their kind of game, and come away with a win.
It's time now to recognize our player of the game.
Well, you get on one of these hot streaks, Gary, and all you can do is sit back and watch. It's an incredible show when it's happening. Spraying the ball all over the field, one just happened to leave the ballpark. That's why he's the player of the game.
And you don't often get the bats going on the road quite like this. Pretty good offensive attack.
Well, when you're on the road, to have this kind of offense, it takes the hometown crowd out of the game and really helps your chances.
Well, that time again. Thanks for being with us today, Major League Baseball. For Steve Phillips, Sean Kruk, and the rest of our great 2K Sports crew, I'm Gary Thorne. Thanks, everybody.